What is up, Trick or Squad? Welcome back to the banger video. Today we're gonna be carving some pumpkins. So we just went to Walmart right now, so flashback. So as you guys saw, we did not only just get pumpkins, we also got prime. Surprisingly, we have not taste tested that yet. So we're gonna be doing
that. Never tried it.
Yeah, we need to taste that.
Taste test.
Yes, we do. So before we carve those pumpkins, which is outside right now, we're gonna taste test this prime. We got all the flavors except for ice pop. We couldn't find that one, but anyways, pull out the prime.
We got all pretty much the general flavors.
And we're gonna try it out at the same time. So we also got
little tiny shot glasses.
I got the pink one, Noah's got that blue one.
So what do you wanna start off with?
Let's start off with grape.
Grape?
Yeah.
So we're gonna put these to the side and crack open the grape.
Noah's only had those samples because his friend got prime at school before, but we have not tried all these flavors. Logan Paul and KSI's energy drink.
Yep.
Here we go, Divosia.
Divosia. That's quite good.
That's really good. It's honestly a better tasting version of cough medicine.
I can't disagree with from that.
Hold on. The grape one honestly tastes like this. A better version though.
Just better.
A better version, a sweeter one. So I'm gonna finish this and I'll catch you guys in a sec. Alrighty guys, I finished my sample and I also cleaned out or we rinsed out our little shot glasses. So next we're gonna try out, which one is this, lime? This one is lemon lime right there.
Let's crack this open.
Crack it open, bubs. Got my sample.
There we go. Like a really soft tint.
It does.
Here, let's see if we could get that on camera.
Light tint to it. Yeah. As you can see, a real light tint of green.
In person, it just looks like water.
It does. Ready to take a shot?
Divosia. That's quite good.
That is good.
I like that.
What does that taste like? I've tasted that flavor before.
I know, I have too.
That's really good. The lemon lime one.
So are we gonna rate them?
Okay, so what do we rate the grape?
Maybe a 7?
7, it's good. It's really good. But will we see ourselves getting it again?
No. What about the lime?
Lime, I'll give it an 8.
An 8?
Okay. Yeah.
We're gonna go rinse these out.
We're
so
gonna
we
rinse
get
out.
Yep. Any flavor from it.
Next, we're gonna try out the blue one. So what flavor is the blue?
The blue is blue raspberry.
You can see that right there?
It's a tint of blue.
Yeah, a soft tint. It's like gray.
It doesn't really have too much blue to it. See if I could get that without spilling it. As you can see, it's more like gray than blue.
Smells good.
Actually, it does. Really good. That smells like, what's that stuff that we used to get at the malls? Like the little tiny
Dippin' Dots?
Yeah, this smells like Dippin' Dots.
Oh, this smells nice.
Time for a shot.
Divosia. That also tastes like the Dippin' Dots.
Oh my gosh. All these taste familiar.
It does.
They taste like Dippin' Dots.
Sorry, I need one more.
Next, we're gonna try out the red one, which I think is Fruit Punch, Tropical Punch. The red one is Tropical Punch. So we're gonna go rinse out our shot glasses and then we'll try out the last flavor.
What do we rate this one?
Oh
like
yeah.
A 9.
That's like a 9. So let's go rinse them out.
Yep.
Alrighty, next is the Tropical Punch. So crack that one open.
Oh, that's hard.
This one's hard to open.
You get it.
You get it?
Nice. This one got more of a red tip.
Go show them that. Looks like orange pink.
See if you could get it like a little shot. See, it's a little orange, but it's more red.
Time for a shot. Divosia.
That's good, isn't it?
That's a 10.
10.
That is a 10.
Yeah. So the rating goes.
This one was like a 7.
8.
8.
Whoa, we got them all in order.
9, and that one was a 10. So the both ones that I recommend are the red and blue. These ones are like one-time use. Well, this one is like a two-time use.
Yeah.
But they are really, really good. So anyways, let's go on and carve some pumpkins. Ow.
Yeah.
Bubba Jack, because if you guys didn't know, that is Noah's nickname, and I tend to call him Bubba a lot. So he picked out Bubba Jack right there. So this is yours.
Thank you.
And I picked out Tiptoe. So I'm gonna be carving out a cat with a little witch hat, and I'm gonna be carving out Grizz, because if you guys didn't know, we have 5 kittens, and this one looks like Grizz. We got all our stuff, we got all of our tools, we got the scooping, we got some knives. So basically, we're gonna cut off the top first, pick out the stem, dig out the guts, and then we'll get right to carving. Ready, Bubs?
Let's go.
Let's get right into it. Already, Noah, so you're gonna go first because we only have one big scooper and one big knife. So
yep.
Noah's just gonna carve out the top. And while you're doing that, we're gonna ask you some questions. So this is also gonna be a little interview. Just for the people who don't know, what is your favorite color?
Blue.
And what is your favorite thing to do on your free time?
Play games.
And what is your favorite video game?
Call of Duty.
What do you tend to play all the time?
Fortnite.
What grade are you in?
6th.
When is your birthday?
August 6th.
What is your favorite sport?
Basketball.
If you go to a playground right now, what obstacle are you getting on first?
The spider web.
And if you didn't know, and to the people who didn't know, that is way too close to the stem. What are you doing?
Okay.
All right, guys, we moved locations. We're right next to the trampoline, and we got this big wooden table. We also got some fold-out chairs. I got my pink one, and Noah got his blue one. So Noah is about finished carving his.
There we go.
I got mine right here, and I'm going to start carving out the top.
Let's go.
Right now.
Now I'm going to start scooping the guts.
And we got this big thing right here. And we also got a bucket for all of the guts.
I'm going to cut this off.
Okay.
Whoa, this is so tiny.
Honestly, just let the knife here. Do its work.
Can I see that real quick? Jeez. How'd you do that so fast?
Let the knife do its work. So I'll see you guys when I'm done taking out the top and I'm scooping out my guts. Alrighty, guys, I got the top off, but it might be too small. Just gotta take this.
Just pull
this off.
It because like the guts are connected to it, the bottom.
I see. There we go. Here, guys. Here's the inside of mine. Gotta chop off this because this will get in the way. Already, it's time to get to scooping. So here we go. Here we go.
A few moments later.
Guys, I was literally just taking out the guts of my pumpkin like I've been doing this entire time. And I was on my chair and I was on my knees. And then the chair breaks and I go and falling on the ground and I hit my knee. I didn't get it on camera because we were literally just taking out the guts, but that really hurt. That was pretty funny though. The chair just broke. But guys, we're pretty much done cleaning out the guts. I mean, this is what mines look like. We're gonna get on with decorating it. We're gonna put this on to the pumpkin, and I'm gonna do Tiptoe, and Noah's gonna do Bubba Jack. So we're gonna do that next scene. So let's do it. All right, guys, it is time to do our design on our pumpkins right here. So Noah got Bubba Jack, I got Tiptoes. So basically my idea is you put this on here and you get this little pick and you just tap it and you trace it out. Then you take off the paper and then you cut it out with the knife. But Noah doesn't really understand what I'm trying to say.
I do.
Okay.
Why don't we just wet it then put it on?
You want the paper on when you're trying to cut?
Yeah, that's how you're supposed to do it.
That's hard. You do your way. I'm gonna do my way. So guys, me and Noah got an easier way from Gramps. So he told us just to cut out our design, like cut out the cat, then either tape it on to the pumpkin, then trace it out with a pen, and then get to cutting. Well, this is not the right knife, but it was the closest one to me. So Noah's gonna do that method as well. So I'm gonna cut out my pumpkin and time lapse. Guys, the funniest thing just happened. I was cutting out my pumpkin and the wind blew Noah's paper into this bucket of water. So now he's gonna take it into the sun for it to dry off.
Where's your paper?
The Bubba Jack.
No. What are the chances that flies perfectly?
It's wet.
Into the bucket.
It literally just flew perfectly while I was swimming the time lapse.
It was like right there on the table and it was like shoo, right into a wet bucket.
Yeah.
So I'm filming a voiceover because this is where I messed up. Instead of cutting out the black like I was supposed to, I cut out the cat, which makes an opposite effect. So basically, the cat was supposed to stay on the pumpkin and the background was supposed to be out. But now the cat is going to be cut out and there's going to be no background except for the pumpkin. And that makes it a lot more uglier and it gives me a lot more problems because I won't be able to cut out the eyes or nothing. Anyways, I figured this out later and yeah, I just need to do this voiceover to clear that up. So back to the video. Time is I taped this template onto my pumpkin and I got this little pick and I was just basically tracing it all out. Now it is time to take off the template because I just finished tracing. Honestly, just rip it off. We won't use it again. And that is what I'm going to be tracing out. So let's get right to it. Guys, I just realized I forgot the eyes. I might need to do that real quick.
Oh, my paper's right here. How can you do eyes?
Great question, Noah. How can I do eyes? Oh, wait, you can't.
Oh, yeah, right here. Here's the eyes. Here's the eyes. I could just put that back on.
You stupid.
But at least I got a face now. Honestly, I should just leave it like this. It looks really good. But now I just need to cut all of this out. So let's get right to work. So guys, Noah finally finished clicking as well. He already did his eyes and the eyebrows are already cut out, but he just finished his face. So now peel off that paper.
I hope I did it right. Oh, yes.
Let's go, Noah.
Yes.
So now we're both on the same part. I'm already cutting. He's going to start cutting right now. We basically did the same thing because he's already cut and I'm already cutting. So yeah, let's get right to work. We were just trying to cut and a bee decides to interrupt us.
No need to be scared.
Do you dare me to move that?
I'll touch the bee. Do you want me to touch it?
Oh! Oh my gosh. Get out of here. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm gonna stop messing with it before I actually get stung. Honestly, a waste of time because I forgot that it's opposite, because the way I did it is I cut out all the black And then I was just gonna put the cat right here, so then it would be opposite. If I were to go with the template and cut out all the black, then the cat would be on and a bunch of stuff on the side will be gone. But I have this cat right here, so maybe I could just like put it on the back or something. I don't know, I could do something with this cat and cut out the eyes. But here is how it came out. Like I said, it's opposite from what I was supposed to do, but it came out good and I made a mistake. I cut this off. I didn't cut it off, but when I was trying to yank out the cat, this fell off. So that's actually supposed to be in. I'm gonna find out something to do with this cat. Maybe I could put it on the other side, like I said, but I'm gonna try to clean this up and I'll see you guys in a sec. Guys, I decided to make a circle that's going around the cat, and I'm just gonna cut all of that out and maybe just put this cat right there in the middle since I did an opposite. So just cut all of this out, then maybe find a way to just stick it right there. I'll see you guys in a little while. Also, real quick, Noah finished his Bubba Jack, so we'll get more montage shots of that, but he's just cleaning it up. And how long did this take in your opinion, Noah?
Like an hour, 2 hours.
Dang. So there is Bubba Jack, and yeah. Alrighty guys, so I just cut out this big old circle and all of the guts are inside, so I'll need to dump that out. But my idea was now I could put the cat right inside somehow, maybe put some toothpicks, and there we go. Like I said, since I did an opposite on accident, I had to do the hard way, but I think it's gonna end up working out just the same. I'll see you guys with the finished result, and here's the finished montage. Just came out, and it took us a while, and I even had to go down the hard road, but I think it came out good, and I'm surprised I got to take a photo shoot with Grizz. I'm really happy that she stayed still. And another thing, I have Halloween earrings. One jack-o'-lantern and the other one is a bat. Can you guys see that? That was not really necessary, but I'm gonna end the video there. So you guys like it, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, hit that little bell so you know if I post a video, and I'll see you guys like vlog, video, skit. Peace.